Well, gender-based violence, as it relates to women who are in politics, takes different forms. It takes both forms of physical violence, and women are violated against both within their own political parties and between political parties. I've been a subject of gender-based violence both within my own political party at the formation of the MDC. At the time that we were running primary elections, my very first introduction to politics, in fact, primary election politics. I was attacked, the vehicle that I was in was attacked as a way of the youths there showing their disagreement or their way of saying they don't agree with the election results. But I've also been a subject of gender-based violence as I went out campaigning as an opposition female member of parliament. At the times that we're campaigning, we've had to be faced with a number of attacks from those that we're contesting against. I've been a subject of gender-based violence that is state-sponsored. I've been beaten up at places where we've been holding marches by riot police. But I think we also need to understand that it's just not physical. It is also very verbal. In fact, the last 2 months, I was subjected to a lot of that verbal abuse. Now on the social media, which has become an arena in which faceless people can continuously abuse you and you are unable to get back to them. Or they'll set up WhatsApp groups and they'll bring you up into a group so that they can abuse you. You can also have gender-based violence against you as a politician within your own family. I believe that part of the issues that I faced after my husband's death around issues of inheritance, although a lot of women face the same problems, but I think mine was particularly much more because it was felt that, you know, the more I was harassed, I would feel it more because I was in a political space. And would probably have preferred for those issues to happen and not necessarily be put in the public sphere. But there was a lot of stuff that was put in the public sphere. I was put out as a person who would have killed my husband. I was put out as a woman of loose morals. So violence is not necessarily just limited to issues of physical violence. It then becomes gender-based violence because it brings in all sorts. Psychological abuse, the verbal abuse that goes with it. The good thing about our culture is that when you do get sick or when you break down, you do have support systems at home. You have family that can look after you, family that can talk to you. Like I said, I was fortunate that my family could understand that this was a clinical issue, that this was a physical problem. But I've also seen people who, when they fall into those kinds of problems, they then get taken over by superstition. So it's either you have been bewitched and they go off the rail because you then go to Mapostori or you go to traditional healers and some of them only make it worse because, you know, when you get through certain abuses, what gets affected is your perceptions about things and your mental situation is about how you perceive things, how you perceive processes. And if people begin to feed fear and begin to feed issues during that time, it can actually worsen your position. So I think support systems are not as good as they should be because these things are not openly spoken about within our own society.